guys, and welcome back. If this is your first time here, my name is Ashley with Ashley Nicole Photography. I have been a professional photographer for 10 years now. Today we're going to be talking about focal lengths, what they do, why you use different ones, and how to choose what focal length is best for you and whatever it is you're shooting. I'm going to talk a little bit about focal lengths, and then I'm going to show you in action using different focal lengths shooting the same subject. There are three main things that different focal lengths will do. One, it changes the perspective. Two, it compresses the background. And three, it affects your depth of field. I'm going to go into each of these different things and explain how the focal lengths affect it. First of all, it affects your perspective. So what I mean by that is it affects the amount of background that's in your photo. A wide angle lens obviously will show more of the background, and a zoomed in lens will show less of the background. This is about where most people stop. This is where their knowledge of focal length ends. So I wanted to start here. The wider you go, the more you see in the picture, the more zoomed in, the longer focal length, the less you see of the background. Okay, next is compression. Now, what is compression? Let's just say that 50 millimeter is around where your eye sees. So to get any wider or any more zoomed in than that, you're going to distort your image. So to get wider, you are distorting in kind of a ballooned effect. So I'm going to show you a picture of Kylie with 100 and a 35, and look at the difference of her face. The 35 millimeter looks more like her face is ballooned up, and the 100 millimeter is more compressed. So kind of think of a funhouse mirror, where if you were to bend the mirror to make you look wider or bend it in to make you look skinnier, that's kind of the same principle as a zoomed in and zoomed out. Zoomed in and zoomed out lens. So compression, what does it do? So in a zoomed in lens, so I use 100 millimeter almost all the time. I love my 100 millimeter. It compresses the background. So what does that do in reality? Compression basically makes your background look closer and bigger. So it makes it look like there is less distance between your subject and the background. So if you take a picture of, say you're at a monument and you take a picture with a wide angle lens, is gonna make the monument look further away. If you take the photo with a more zoomed in lens, it's going to look closer to your subject and bigger to your subject. And it's going to look bigger. So here's a picture of Kylie with in the same spot with the same tree behind her. But if you notice the wider angle lens, the tree looks skinnier. And in the more zoomed in lens, the tree looks fatter. So it compresses that background. It makes the background look bigger and closer to your subject. I hope that made sense. The third thing is depth of field. So how do the different focal lengths affect your depth of field? If you refer back to my first video where I talked about the different settings and getting that blurry background, so that's just part of it. The settings that you choose, your f-stop that you choose to get that blurry background is part of it. But the focal length is a big part of it. So if I'm taking a picture with a 35 millimeter lens, I am in the same spot as I take a photo with a 100 millimeter lens. The background with the same f-stop is going to be a different amount of blurriness. So the depth of field that you're getting is going to be different. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, please watch that first video so you can get caught up. The 35 millimeter, I'm gonna show you a couple pictures again. The 35 millimeter, you're going to have less of a blur. You're gonna have more detail in the background from the same distance with the same f-stop than you are 100 millimeter, and that has to do with the compression of the background. So if you're trying to get a super blurry background with a 35 millimeter lens, to get the same level of blur, you're going to have to be closer to your subject, and your subject needs to be further from the background than you would with a more zoomed in focal lens. That's kind of an overview of what the different focal lengths do. So how do you choose what focal length is right for you? Okay, so first I'm gonna explain why I personally love to shoot with my 100 millimeter lens. A lot of portrait photographers shoot with a 50 millimeter lens, and there is nothing wrong with that. That is a beautiful, perfect lens, a great all-around lens that you can use for so many things. So if you don't know where to start, a 50 millimeter is great. I like my 100 millimeter because it gives me a little bit different look than all the other photographers. It gives me more of a focus on my subject because it's compressing that background. It's also blurring that background. My focus is more on my subject. So if I'm in a location though where I'm taking pictures of architecture or beautiful nature with a subject, I will use a 35 millimeter. But a lot of times I want to focus on that subject. So I personally like 100 millimeter for the look that it gives. So you just really need to figure out what it is that you like, what you're shooting, what the look is you're going for, and choose a lens based on that. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you a few clips of me and Kylie out shooting with these four different lenses. I'm gonna try and make this as seamless as possible. Kylie is the model and she is filming, so we're passing the vlogging camera back and forth, so hopefully I can make this look seamless, but we're gonna go ahead and jump into that. I'm gonna take photographs of Kylie with different focal lengths from the same spot, and then also from different focal lengths with the same cropping. So you can see the different, what the different focal lengths do to the background and then also to the subject. So Kylie's gonna stand here and yes, let's do this, stop it. So you see Kylie here, and this is what the background looks like. This is where I was standing. We have a nice pathway, some leading lines. We have some trees around her. So you're gonna be able to see the background and how it changes with different focal lengths.
This is the 135, people don't know.
My f-stop stays constant through all these pictures. I'm leaving my settings the exact same. And I want you to notice as we go through these, this is 35 and the 50. Put those side by side. And then you'll notice as we go along, even though the f-stop is the same, the background becomes blurrier the more zoomed in the lens is. So what is the background doing right now? One, you're letting in, you're seeing more of the background in the wider angle lenses. In the zoomed in lens, it makes what's behind her appear bigger. So what I'm doing in these is I'm taking a photo of her and I'm trying to keep it cropped at the bottom of her sweatshirt. So I am moving because the lens is different. So with the 35, I am like up close in her face to get that crop. And then the 135, I had to walk way back here to get that shot the same. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna get a picture of her and me staying in the same spot and changing lenses. So you can get a better representation of the amount of background versus how zoomed in the 135 is. Does that make sense? Kylie's nodding, so hopefully that makes sense to you too. Kylie is there. I'm here. I am now gonna take pictures of her. So I'm going to take pictures of her right here with all four lenses and then show you what that looks like. All right, so you can see from this set of pictures that, again, I was stationary, she was stationary. So you can see the amount. In the 35, you have a full body shot. By the time we get to the 135, it is, she's so pretty. It is much, much cropped in, and you look, again, the background is so, so blurry. Knowing what your lenses do, knowing what those focal lengths do will help you achieve what it is that you're wanting. So I want a picture here where I can see a winding trail going behind her. I know this is straight, but if I wanted to see the winding trail, I would use a little bit wider of a lens. Because if you look here, the zoomed in lens is not showing the trail, it's showing very, very blurry background, so you don't even know what's behind her really. And it doesn't show the windingness. It compresses the background where you're not seeing that winding. So why would this be good? Again, it depends on the situation you're in and what you're looking for. But say you're in a really crowded place trying to take pictures where there's photographers everywhere, you don't want to get the whole background in. If you use a more zoomed in lens, you can help eliminate some of that background. So a lot of times I will use it, say I've got a couple and there's people walking behind them. With a compressed lens, a zoomed in lens, I can get to where their entire head will cover everybody behind them because it's compressing that background. But if I use a wide angle lens, it's gonna capture all the stuff going on in the background that you don't want. So I hope this was helpful, and we're gonna go back to Ashley in the studio. All right, so that is it on focal lengths. I hope that this helped. I hope this makes sense. If you have any questions, please leave them below. I will answer them to the best of my ability. If you have any requests for what you want to see next, please leave that in the comments below as well. And I hope that y'all have a wonderful Christmas. It is coming up fast, and I will see you guys next time. Bye. So Kylie's face is gonna, if I can do this handheld and still, her face is gonna stay in the same crop, if that makes sense, but the background changes because I'm going to zoom the lens in while moving back. How cool is that? Everybody, thank Kylie for being my camera woman and my model. She is a rock star.
Two, why do I keep blanking on everything I want to say?
Oh, that's bad light.
There's science behind it, I promise. Why can't I talk today?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Is it because you're cold?
Yes, I am cold. Do you ever know that you're smart, but you know you sound dumb?
Yeah.
And cut.